let's get into it. It's Lex here showing you behind the scenes of Future of Flea. If you don't know, I am the creator and organizer of it. If you don't know what Future of Flea is, it is basically a flea market in New York City. Yes, that is right. I started out in Los Angeles hosting markets, moved out here, had to take it with me, and I'm gonna show y'all the behind the scenes of it. But fun fact, I'm also moving out of my building, so after I do my makeup, I have to clear everything out, and then I'm taking 3 suitcases with me to work, and then right after work, I've got to catch a flight. So it's pretty quick, bam, bam, bam. I'm gonna show y'all how I do it, and take y'all along with me for the ride. Hey y'all, so I just finished my makeup. I'm gonna throw on an outfit and literally throw what is left in my room away. And I'm honestly just gonna head out of here with 3 suitcases, head to my market, show y'all that little process. I wasn't like talking, I was tripping out. I was like, why does my face look weird? It's because I literally only have mascara on one eye. So I'm gonna go do that. Imagine I walk out the house like that, that'd be crazy. Anyways, yeah, I wasn't really trying to like wake my roommate up, and I literally can't even remember, which is the worst of it. Hold up. Today's gonna be a good day. I'm gonna make it a good day. Okay guys, I'm gonna catch y'all once I'm changed and ready to head out the door.
I didn't have any other clothes that I didn't pack, so here's the fit.
Hey y'all.
We got the stove. So I forgot to like record me leaving my building. He got an everything bagel. No, he got an everything bagel. Where's my olive? I'm just getting a water to stay hydrated.
My bad.
Raining, but I hope people still come to the event. It's like down the block. And I'm gonna go set up right now. Squinting
because
it's raining.
7 out of 10.
7 out of 10?
7 out of 10.
You're 7 out of 10?
No, I said it first.
Nah, you just copied me.
Hey y'all, I'm here setting up for my market now. So what I have to do pretty much is measure the vendor spaces. It's like the dimensions are 10x5. So in LA I do it a lot differently since it's small here. I use the Vet Measure app on iPhone, and then I just use this. Every iPhone user has this app, it's called Measure. Open it and you can literally measure everything, and I just measure 10x5 feet, and then I use a sticky note, a sticky note to denote the entire space. It's pretty simple, I do about 15 of those by myself, but it's light work.
This is like one space between these. And then we ended up bringing a pop-up dressing room because people were spending 2 hours in line. And then we have some messy tea. What other flavors do we have?
Raspberry, hibiscus, and peach.
All the vendors are setting up now. Their bathroom in that corner. We got East Coast Moon setting up her booth. It's honestly raining, so I'm kind of scared that people won't come. Because I know when it's raining, I just like stay inside. The rain really makes me depressed.
But shopping makes me happy, so. I think y'all need some retail therapy. So y'all should pop out to Future of Flea. This is the last one of this season at least. I might continue them in the fall, but I doubt there will be any ones in the summer.
Marcus, do you have anything to say?
Totally.
Really love this jacket. I get so sad because there's so much men's stuff that are cute, but it's just huge on me.
Can't forget the denim.
Oh, this might fit me. $60 though, I don't know, I might just take it. But yeah. Super slay. See, honestly, if you're looking for a jacket and you're not at Future of Flea, you're definitely missing out. Dresses are actually the cutest. Hold up. My favorites were over here. They're skirts, maybe? Not sure. But they're just very gorgeous. A lot of them are dead stock. She's actually the wholesale plug, so if you want some wholesale Y2K, anything vintage, hit up East Coast Moon. Honestly, never disappoints. I always buy stuff from her when she's selling. Lots of 90s slips, lots of everything. Oh my god,
so cute.
Wait, her stuff is so cute.
I know, I was just looking at this.
I'm literally trying to hold my camera up on a soap dispenser. Anyways, now it's bathroom break. Gonna touch up the lipstick. And yeah, so after I'm done setting up for the vendors have an hour to set up their stuff. You know, like their clothing racks and whatnot. And I pretty much just chill for a whole hour. And then I chill for 6 more hours while people shop. But you know, my friends are here. It's a vibe. Hopefully, I mean, the turnout will be good again. I just have to manifest it. Yeah, when shoppers start coming, I'm back.
So they're trying to figure out the setup. He always brings Miss Brittany.
Looking pretty good at night.
I actually love this setup. They're super smart for bringing double racks. Don't have anything for it. I think this shirt's super cute. Cute little jean rack going on. Some trees. Now we got some shoppers in here. Everyone's all set up.
Oh, so let me show you guys this new hoodie that I'm obsessed with. Marcus, record the back of my hoodie.
Yeah. What button do I click?
It's already recording.
Okay.
It's from Unbearable Apparel. $45. Super cute. I love the song.
Yeah. I didn't know you were a Take fan.
I am a Take fan. Free Take.
Nice.
We got some free tea. It's actually really bomb. And I also got, I need to stop buying because I have a flight after this. But it was only $5, so I have to. It's an vintage Looney Tunes mug from
98.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you. It's handmade.
Come here, come here.
Some more really good finds. I like this purse a lot, especially because I have this Burberry shirt. It feels perfectly. And I like this shoe too. They're only $20.
I tried these shoes on. You know, I really do love them. But
my name's Natalie. My shop is Vegas Baby Dolls. My favorite pieces are this vest.
Yes.
It's giving like Free People, but it's called Star.
And vintage. Free People copied
yes.
them.
Yes, really cute. Also, this vest is really cute because of like the side details.
And she literally got a logo offer on this piece, but it's so gorgeous. Why do you like it?
It's just like so like lacy and like weight and like cute for the summertime.
Very cute. Piece in your booth?
My favorite piece?
Yeah.
The Betty Boop.
I love everything Betty Boop, but they're all too big for me.
Yeah. They're all, like always XL, so. My favorite piece.
Oh yeah, I saw that. That was really dope.
Jeff Gordon, Jeff Hamilton leather jacket, yo. Super cool all around. I had a Sesame Seed bagel today. That was great. Yes.
Oh.
Everyone's like packing their stuff. Oh, they got their stuff. I think I'm gonna change into more comfortable clothes because I'm literally heading to the airport like right now. We're gonna get something to eat first. But yeah, I didn't sell today. I usually sell at Alco Market, but futuristically, I just like to organize. I literally do it for the people. I don't even like care to really make too much money. As long as the vendors are happy, I'm happy.
Hold on, hold on. Oh, it's about to go.
Oh.
how would you rate today?
10 out of 10.
Yeah, you heard him. How would you rate today?
0 out of 0.
Like your face.
So, I ordered some Jersey Mike's, and I literally got what I didn't want. I'm not a ham girly, I'm a turkey girly, but guess what? I literally got ham. So now I have to eat this sandwich that doesn't even like fulfill my craving. We're gonna take these kiddos home.
You guys can call him uncle.
Call him uncle Mark.
Uncle Mark's gonna take him home now. Do you guys have anything to say to the YouTube channel before I go?
You know, subscribe, hit that like button.
And bye, guys. To check my bags in, and honestly, this was the day. Like, after this, like, I'm gonna be in California, and anyways, I'm gonna go to sleep and wake up and be in California tomorrow. So, thanks for tuning in. Talk to y'all later. New York City.